A while back, I made a video of how to connect your Xbox controller to a receiver when you get an error of unknown device. But recently, Windows 10 has updated and it's now Windows 10 2004 version, which doesn't allow the same method anymore. So in this video, I'm gonna show you the new method that would work for Windows 10 version 2004. Let's get started. Let's connect the receiver to the computer by plugging into a USB plug. The light should turn on green. Now I've connected the adapter and you can see nothing has happened after connecting. The light on the receiver has turned on, but we don't see any signs of any connection. So what we need to do is now to go to the start and right click here and then click on Device Manager. And if you come here, you can see under Device Manager, Other Devices, and we have got now an unknown device. So now you need to right click on it and then click on Properties. Then you need to go to the Details tab. In the Details tab, on the Property drop-down, you need to select Hardware IDs. Here we have two Hardware IDs. So meanwhile, open a Notepad. Go to your start and type in Notepad, click on and select it, and just type in the last four digit of the ID that looks more like this. So which is 02A9. Press Ctrl S to save it. Give it a name if you want to, or just any name. Click Save. Then we need to go to the Microsoft download site. I will provide a link in the description of this video. Here in the software and driver, select the version of your Windows and then click on Xbox 360 accessory software, then click on Save. And now we need to right click on it and click on Extract here, and you can see the folders created in here and some of the files. Now click on Xbox 360 folder. Double click the setup 64, double click the files, double click the driver, double click Windows 7. And then what we are interested is this item which says setup info. The icon looks like this. Just right click it and click on open with and then select notepad. Click on OK. You can see here the number that we are interested is this, and this needs to be replaced wherever it is stated in this document with the new number that we got. So Ctrl C to copy this number. So now select these four digits, then click on Edit, and then click on Replace. So these four digits are selected now to be replaced with the one that we just copied. Press Ctrl V to paste that. You can click on Match Case and then click on Replace All. You can see now it is replaced with the one that we just copied. So now we can close this, press Ctrl S to save it, and then close it. So to install it, we need to go through another hurdle. And for that, we need to enter to the test mode. To do that, we need to again right click on the start and click on Windows PowerShell. To get to the test mode, I'll put these commands in the description. You need to select this command from the description and paste it in here, and then if you press enter, the operation completely successfully, and then you have to close all your files, all the programs, and click and restart your computer. So you can see that now we are in the test mode because the watermark is on and saying test mode. This will allow us to install now the drivers. So double click again on the folder Xbox 360, setup, files, driver, Win7. And now you have to right click on the file, setup information, and click on install. Scary message saying it can't verify, even though this is a Microsoft software and a driver, but it doesn't trust its own driver. Well, just click on install this driver software anyway. And after some time, you will see the operation completed successfully. Click OK. So you need to right click on the start and select Windows PowerShell admin, And now copy and paste this command to the PowerShell and click on enter. The operation completed successfully. Then we can close everything and once again go and restart your computer. And now you can see the watermark is gone. Once again, right click on the start and select device manager. And here we are. At the bottom, you can see the Xbox 360 peripherals are activated, and now you should be able to connect your Xbox controller to your Xbox receiver. And now just press the start button for a few seconds and you can hear it is connected. I hope this video was useful. If it was, please don't forget to watch my other videos on my left and to subscribe to support my channel. I hope to see you in my next video. Bye-bye.